2 years ago, 19-year-old Helen Slater left Manhattan's famous High School of Performing Arts to find the kind of fame for which other actors struggled in Alan Parker's brilliant film and the subsequent television spin-off about the school's student population. The lovely lady's chance came from the legendary Sulkins, the veteran Alexander and his equally talented son, Ilya. We glimpse the success story of Ilya Sulkin and his partner, Pierre Spengler, in this edition of the Electric Theatre Show. The gateway to a world of pure fantasy, the fantasies created by filmmakers.
Supergirl.
Rooted in an almost lifelong friendship and a mutual fascination with movies, the Sulkin-Spengler filmmaking philosophy is similar to that of Spielberg and George Lucas. Big, happy entertainment. The two-headed hydra, as Spengler calls his partnership with Sulkin,
for his high fee. The character might not have measured up to those in On the Waterfront and A Streetcar Named Desire, but the actor gave it the dignity of believability.
Specific charges listed herein against these individuals, their acts of treason, and ultimate aim of sedition. These are matters of undeniable fact.
In a film about the making of Superman the movie, Brando was also afforded the chance to scotch ugly rumors about his ability to learn and retain his lines.
There's nothing more boring than a director who directs an actor to, then you look at the cue card, but it gives you the feeling as the viewer, hopefully, that the person is really searching for what he's going to say. He doesn't know what he's going to say.
These are matters of undeniable fact. I ask you now to pronounce judgment on those accused, whose only expression is wanton violence and destruction. And on the woman, Eartha, whose perversions and unreasoning hatred of all mankind have finally threatened even the children of our planet.
There are a lot of marvelous actors, and I think it's more than an actor. He has become a legend, he has become a myth.
I was always impressed.
1977 was the year in which the Sulkins and Spengler really took off.
Now, the first thing we got to do when we get home is find out who that boy's proper family is.
He hasn't got any. Not around here, anyway.
Martha, are you thinking what I think you're thinking?
We could say he's the child of my cousin in North Dakota, and just now orphaned.
Oh, Martha.
Jonathan, he's only a baby.
Martha, now you saw how we found him, you know. Martha, Clark Kent, are you listening to what I'm saying?
Christopher Reeve won the coveted role, and so began his physical struggle to match up to Superman.
The point is, when I started, I was a string bean, and Superman...
Don't just sit there like a numbskull. Get out!
I think he's coming, Mr. Luthor.
It is, of course, inevitable that such adventures, intended as they are as entertainments, should come under fire from critics who seek a more meaningful fare. But characteristically, Salkind and Spengler appear to take the paying public's assessment of the legendary character more seriously.
At the beginning, we had to be extremely careful on
that. And it's reported that Swark welcomed the opportunity offered to him by Elias Salkind and Timothy Beryl, who took over the producer's reins from Pierre Spengler, because he believes that, apart from Barbarella and Maria Montez, there has been no real female mythology in the history of the cinema. Also, like Salkind, he's an earnest believer in the return of pure romanticism to films. But the young producer, who was once warned by his father to stop living the life of a bum, had more down-to-earth reasons for making the film.
The girl syndrome was really to try to prove something different.
His usual contribution to his friend's latest film, it's clear that he shares Elias Salkind's firm belief in the need for stability. In the middle of all the chaos around us, he says, we need a continuity, like the British monarchy, Superman, and of course, Supergirl.
Now this I like.
Hello.
Hello, she says.
Well, hello to you, honey bun.
Hello. I was wondering if you could tell me where I am.
What do they call this place, Eddie? Lover's Lane, isn't it?
You got it in one, Billy boy. Lover's Lane.
Oh, no. You see, what I meant was, well, those lights over there, what are they called?
Check out the view from back here, Eduardo. Ah,
stop hey. That.
You're Superman's best friend, huh?
No. His cousin. I've come here to search for the Omega Hedron. It's a power source vital to Argo City. You see, that's where I live.
No kidding. Eddie and me, we're on a secret mission also. We're out looking for a good time. And you just won the brass ring, baby. Oh, she works out, huh?
Why are you doing this?
It's just the way we are.
You shouldn't have done that, baby. Come on. You really want to play games, eh, sweetheart? Come on. Come on. Huh? Eddie, I think maybe we should kind of keep this to ourselves.
Thank you.
Next on TSW, the news at 1 and TSW's news headlines.